But we're going to do the same step on the other side first. So, this is folding over. Folding this inside out. Pulling this paper out. And then by pushing this paper inside, you get triangle shapes. Then again, fold this back. So you've got this. And then, guess what? Turn it around and do the same thing on the other side. And then what we've got is this. Got our triangles here. Okay. What we do next is, on each of these triangles, you basically open them up. Maybe from this side. Open them up. And then you squash them down. Like so. Right, so that's kind of before. You open. Squash like that. Okay. Then you bring one point down. And now on this side we're going to fold a rabbit ear. On this side. So you fold this edge to the middle, fold that edge to the middle. Then you get your creases. And when you've got your rabbit ear, I want you to fold this point back and forth a bit, because that's going to be helpful for the next step. Okay, so the next step is, basically, you see you've got two layers here, and you want to bring one of the layers outside. So you try to get some hold of some paper, and you kind of pull on it. So this paper comes outside, and then there's the creases done there already. So you just fold along those creases that are there. And then what you've got is this, okay? Now, look inside here, there's some paper, and on that paper, see that? There's some paper, pull on it, pull it out, and here there's a valley fold, and then you get this. And on the top, it's exactly the same. So this is what you had before, and this is what you have after. Open this up, take the paper, and pull it out. And once you've pulled it out, flatten it out nicely. There's the top. Okay. When you've done that, you want to fold one layer over. And then you're going to fold this bit up. And then you close it. And you do that same thing on the other side. Right, so what did we do? Had this. Then we took some paper to open up the second half of that rabbit ear forward. Then you go along the creases that are already there. And you get this. And then you take the paper that's trapped in there and pull it out. On the bottom, and on the top. So if you've got thicker paper in these steps, you might have to be careful not to rip any paper. I think I remember that these steps, you had to be careful with that, with other paper. Then you fold one layer back, fold this up, and then you go back to the center. And because that was fun, let's do the same thing on the other side. First, open this, then fold one point down, and on here, do the rabbit ears again. When you've done this on both sides, we're going to fold these points up. By the way, if you're wondering if you see any more white paper, the only times when you actually do see white paper I've mentioned, and from then on, we never actually see white paper. It's always colored paper. Okay, so now we've kind of got these triangles with a rectangle on the bottom. And those we're going to make a mountain fold here and a valley fold here, I'm sorry, and a mountain fold on the angle bisector. And what you get is in the top you're going to do something like a petal fold, I guess. Up until, well, not quite, you're going to do a triangle there. Right, see that triangle. Up until basically this crease that you've got here, which is the middle. And on the rest, you're going to do like diagonal folds, so you kind of get a kite shape. See that? It's kind of like a kite shape. And the flap you've got on the top, just fold it to one side. Like so. And then, to kind of complete this shape, you've got to inside reverse fold this bit.